Hello, I'm Natalia Pianzola from BBC Mundo. You'll probably use YouTube on a pretty frequent basis, like me.
And join the global conversation.
Every day a friend will send me a link or I click on a video via Facebook or Twitter. Isn't it incredible to think it's only been around since 2005? In the early days, a lot of these videos were quirky,
ow!
Funny,
ow, jolly, ow! Jolly, that really hurts.
Silly.
Hey, Apple.
What?
Hey, Apple.
What?
Can you do this? No, 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 no,
no, no. Or simply boring.
One of the elephants. Cool thing about these guys is that they have really, really, really long trunks, and that's cool.
Now things are changing, but how and why should we be interested?
The reason why the BBC World Service should be on YouTube, and especially languages, is twofold, and that's two numbers. One is that YouTube has got 1 billion visitors monthly, and the other one is that YouTube accounts for between 50 and 20% of all internet traffic. To me, that is enough justification that we should be on YouTube and we should capitalize on YouTube.
Most of our language services have a YouTube channel, but a lot are automated. Therefore, what goes on the website automatically ends up on the channel. But should we be aiming for distinctive content?
If you're looking at the social audience and also an online engagement, people care about having somebody behind that screen. They'd like to see somebody who's actually investing themselves and talking to the audience and also engaging with the audience. So I think just pumping out the same content that you have on your different platforms is not going to work on YouTube. It really needs a customized, tailored approach.
One thing that we do provide is the BBC online and on television and radio are analysts. We have a bundle of them, they come to visit us all the time, we talk to them about various events around the world. But what YouTube is all about is about the real people on the ground.
Shot from behind.
In the fucking melee.
Some people say BBC News has been late to the YouTube party, only recently realizing the potential to reach new audiences. So, what are other news providers doing?
You know, there's this code on TV of what you can and can't say. We don't give a damn about that code.
Not buying it, illegal.
Is that true at all?
Ricky Gervais loved that story. We have evidence.
Evidence.
And that's the problem with Democrats and Republicans in the first place. They always agree on screwing us.
At more than 1.4 million subscribers, ABS-CBN, based in the Philippines, is the most followed news outlet on YouTube. It posts a lot of short videos from its TV channel, but offers little bespoke content.
Not everything that fits broadcast will be right for our online platforms. On our YouTube channels, you'll find the juice of RT, the most interesting and trendy videos, only best shows and interviews. During the past few years, we've been closely monitoring what our audience watch and upvote most, what topics spark fierce discussions. And by listening to what our audience wants, we managed to create one of the most active news communities on YouTube, with 1.1 million subscribers and 1.1 billion views and still counting.
Hi, I'm Dina Takuri with AJ Plus. You might remember Nelson Mandela as this man, the peacemaker who led South Africa post-apartheid. But to really understand him, you also have to know this man, the young, defiant rebel who was so committed to liberating his country, he was willing to die for the cause. This is a look at Mandela, the rebel.
That's some of the competition, but what are people here at YouTube saying?
They've produced this lengthy document, it's called The Playbook, and it's designed to make your YouTube channel more attractive to audiences. It has lots of information about design, how to deal with comments, annotations, blah, 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 but what's relevant for us?
Hello, my name's Kate Rushworth, and I'm a YouTube strategist. What I think BBC producers and journalists should be thinking about when they're uploading videos to their YouTube channel, things like, how are you packaging it? So thinking about things like the thumbnail and the title. If something is happening and it's breaking news, yes, speed is of the essence, but you want to make sure that people can find it. That is the key thing that people, that YouTube looks for. So we're thinking metadata, tags, good descriptions, descriptive titles. On YouTube, I think news works in a really wonderful, unique way. And I think that the key thing here is the conversation that you can have with your audience. So often personalities can work very well. So just thinking to mind, channels like The Young Turks or SourceFed, we have very strong personalities who deliver the news and you go because you have a relationship with them. But also channels that have a very strong editorial voice. So for example, channels like Truthloader or Russia Today, they have very strong editorial voice, so you know what that channel will deliver. So that's how you can cut above other YouTube channels, is that people understand what it is you will get from your YouTube channel.
Try to integrate into YouTube. Be part of it. Follow the trends. Be fluent in YouTube's language. You have to listen to what your subscribers are saying. Communicate with them. Don't be afraid, for example, to answer in the comment section if necessary. Follow them as they follow you. Their likes, dislikes, views, comments. It's a crucial tool in understanding what they want and where to move editorially.
So why is the BBC doing this? What's the long-term aim of putting our content on YouTube?
This is about saying, if you see that little film and if you like it, then I know that you are going to be curious enough to go and check what the BBC is doing, and then you will come to me. And when you come to me, I will make sure that I keep you and I entice you with other things. This is not the kind of thing that the BBC used to do in the past. This is the kind of thing that Amazon does very successfully and various other organizations. And now the BBC is starting to think, okay, I'm going to go and get you. I'm going to go where you are. I'm going to bring you back. And when I bring you back, I know that I've got an enormous amount to give you. And I'm going to tailor it to your needs and your tastes.
You'll learn a lot more on different ways of using YouTube today. But we hope this video will get you thinking, because in the end, we need to be where the audience is. Good luck with the course.